Henry showed me how to make his flicker, and then we designed a plus flicker together, and now we designed this triple-bladed shuriken, and it flies like this. Yeah, it flies well.
All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 6-inch square of kami. I don't really recommend using a sheet of printer paper, but you can try. Begin white side up and fold in half. Make sure to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and fold to the crease. And repeat. And unfold. Now fold this corner up. We're folding on this point, and we want the corner to land on the crease. And try to make this super exact. And unfold and repeat. Crease sharply and fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with the crease. And repeat. Now these two lengths should be equal. If not, I recommend going back and redoing it so that your folds are more exact. Okay, unfold and fold the corner to here. And repeat. And refold. Rotate and fold the bottom edge to these two points. And fold this flap over the edge. And repeat. Unfold and unfold, refold the corners, and now take this flap and insert it underneath these two flaps. Okay, fold this flap up. We're just folding from here to here. And unfold and repeat on the other two sides. Okay, now fold this edge to this edge. And we're folding from here to here, from the edge to the edge. Hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And unfold and repeat that on the other two sides. Now, rabbit ear. Try to make it come to a clean corner if you can. Okay, and fold the rabbit ear to the left and to the right. And repeat on the other two corners. And again, make sure the rabbit ears go in both directions. Okay. Now we're going to do it again. So, holding the layers together, fold up. And just go around like this again, just so that you have that crease again. I know we already folded it before, but just reinforce it. Okay. Now, pinch the rabbit ear. And make it go both directions. Okay, unfold. And pinch this rabbit ear. Make it go both directions. And unfold. And now this one. Okay, and unfold, and now make them all at the same time. Okay, now we're going to do it one more time. So just worry about this angle right here. So we're going to fold here and here. And this time, just flatten the rabbit ear in one direction. So just flatten it upward, not downward. And when you do this, you want this edge to be parallel with this edge. So it's like half of a hexagon. Okay, and unfold. And now we're going to work on this one. So here and here, make the rabbit ear. And again, collapse the rabbit ear in one direction, upward, not downward. And unfold, and one last rabbit ear. Okay, and now make all three at the same time. And when you make the three at the same time, you'll form a triangle here, just due to the creep of the paper. And that triangle actually kind of helps the flap stay down. Okay, now just go around trying to make it look like a plane. Like all the layers lie in a geometric plane, not an airplane. This is more like a helicopter. Okay, and there it is. And now let's see how it flies. All right, so to fly this, well, first of all, it looks cool, but it's rather difficult to get to fly well. I mean, you can try to flick it like a flicker. It's just not gonna go very far. That went like a foot. Maybe I can do better than that. Okay, that was a little better. But the way that I've had a lot more success is by throwing it like a frisbee and just flicking the heck out of it. But also, I curve the blades upwards. So here's the little triangle is on top, and I'm curving just slightly so that it's a little concave on top. And the other trick I figured out was that if you look carefully, you'll notice that one of the arms is actually thicker than the rest, which is probably why it doesn't fly well. So I found that This is the thick blade. I want that to hit the air first. So instead of holding onto the thick blade, I'm gonna hold onto the one next to it and then just give it a super flick so that the thick blade is what hits the air first. Throw it really hard, give it a lot of wrist and a lot of flick upwards and hope for the best. Let's see how it flies. That was not the best. I can do better than that. Okay, here goes. Just breathe, relax the arm, relax the wrist, and flick it up towards the ceiling. Here goes. Oh yeah. Okay, here goes. Yeah, that was better. Yeah, so that's about as good as I've gotten it to flick. I mean, it tends to go to the right like a boomerang, but it doesn't go all the way around because it doesn't have the right aerodynamic weight and all. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed folding that and enjoy trying to fly it. If you managed to fly it better than me, then let me know how you did it. And I'll see you guys later.